Hello students, today we will start our new chapter, that is server side scripting. We already studied client side scripting, means advanced javascript. We used that language as client side. What is the difference between client-side scripting and server-side scripting? In client-side scripting, we write the program and we execute the program at client side. And in case of server-side, client should activate the program. Client should send the request to the server, then server will execute the program and send the output to the browser of client, that is server side scripting. The code written for the server side is not visible to the client, but the code written in client side is visible to the client. In this server side scripting, we will learn PHP. In this server side scripting, we will learn PHP. First, we'll see what is mean by server side scripting. Server means what? A server means system, means computer system, which acts as central repository of data and programs and is shared by client. Means we have a computer system, on that our data, our programs, all things are saved. Whenever client need that programs, that data, client can access it from that computer system, which is known as server. And web server means what? Web server means the environment, an environment which runs a scripting language. An environment which runs a scripting language. Which language which can use as a server side scripting? We can use PHP, we can use Java or JSP, or we can use Python. These are the languages for server side scripting. Now we have PHP in your syllabus as a server side scripting. So we'll see what is mean by PHP. So the long form of PHP is hypertext preprocessor. In early days, it was known as personal home page. That's why the long form is PHP, personal home page. But it was old name. Now new name, what is the new name? Hypertext preprocessor. Why they given it as hypertext preprocessor? Because this PHP is embedded into HTML. This PHP is embedded into HTML language. That's why it convert the long form is converted into hypertext preprocessor. This is an open source language used for general purpose. Open source means we can download it freely. No need of money to download this language or the server for this language. What we require? We require web server as a PHP parser and web browser. We already have web browser on our system, that is Chrome or our Internet Explorer or our Safari, like that. But we require web server which can be downloaded from the online, which can download online, and it is free. No need of money. That's why it is known as open source language. This PHP can run on any platform like Linux, Unix, macOS, Windows, etc. So it is also known as platform independent language, and it is compatible with all servers. Means it can be run on web servers like XAMPP, Apache, Nginx, LightPD, etc. It supports a wide range of databases. it is very easy to learn and run efficiently on server side. So actually this is most popular and frequently used worldwide server side scripting language. Why? Because of its feature. What are the features it has? It is having first the feature of PHP. First feature is it is very simple language. It is easy to learn, easy to use as compared to other scripting languages. Next, without compilation, we can interpret the output. That's why it is interpreted language. Third one, it is faster than other scripting language. For example, JSP, ASP. As compared to that, this PHP is faster. Next feature is open source. As we already discussed, open source means what? It is available freely. No need to pay for use of PHP. We can freely download and use. Next, it is platform independent, means we can run the code on every platform. For example, any Linux, our operating system may be Linux, may be Unix, may be Windows, or may be Mac OS X. We can run on any platform this PHP language. Next is case sensitive. Now, case sensitive means what? Case sensitive means either we can write in small cases or we can write in capital letters. Like that means case sensitivity. But in case of PHP, it is case sensitive only about variables. It is case sensitive only about variables, not with other names like if, else, for each, or echo. These kind of keywords are not case sensitive. We can write it in capital letters as well as we can write it in small letters. But in case of variables, if you declare the variable with small alphabets, you have to use the variables with small alphabets only. You can't access the variable with capital letters. Why? Because regarding with variables, the PHP is case sensitive. Next feature is error reporting. PHP already have some predefined error constants. So at the time of execution, it will help us by generating or warning error notice. So this is error reporting language. Next feature is real-time access monitoring. It creates the summary of recently accesses of users and it helps to provide easy access or easy logging. It helps by providing easy access or easy logging. So PHP is real-time access monitoring as it gives the summary of recent accesses. Next, loosely typed language. We studied earlier in JavaScript that we need to declare our variable. Then we can use it. But in case of PHP, though we not declare our variable, we can use it directly. Only just take care about case sensitivity about of the name of that variable. Otherwise, declaration, we declared the variable or not declared that variable, it doesn't matter. We can use directly whenever we want. That's why this PHP is also known as loosely typed languages, as it is not makes compulsory to declare variable. Next, see how we can write the code in PHP. PHP is hypertext preprocessor. Why? Because it is embedded within HTML. See, These are the HTML tags. Only the difference is when we are writing PHP language, inside body tag we need to use these PHP with small than and greater than brackets and question mark symbols. What is the syntax? In HTML tag, inside body tag, use less than or greater than symbol, in question marks write PHP. This is the starting tag, this is the ending tag. First, we'll write doc type HTML, next HTML starting tag, next head section. Here I didn't write head section. Next body section. In the body section, whatever the heading you want to display, write that one. Next starting tag for PHP. Next, if you want to print any text on the web browser, then you need to write the keyword echo. E-C-H-O. Echo. Echo used to print the word, any word, on the web browser. Into bracket what you want to print that word. Next end of PHP tag, next end of body section, end of HTML tag. This is the sample program for PHP. In this way we can write our PHP. To write the PHP we need editor like WordPad, Notepad, like that. How we wrote the program for HTML, the program for JavaScript, in similar ways we can write the program for PHP. Just we need one more thing, that is we need web server. That is web server. We will see in next lecture how to download that web server from online and how to save, how to write the program, how to save the program, and how to execute the program. Next, PHP variables. PHP variables. Variable means what? Variable means any symbolic expression which can hold a value. Which can hold a value, and that value may be characters or may be numbers or maybe string or maybe memory address, whatever the value, we can pass any value to that variable. And variable means what? Any symbol, any symbolic name, any symbolic expression that can hold a value. But it has some rules to declare the name of the variable. What are the rules for PHP variable declaration? First rule, that is our variable name must be start with dollar symbol. Our variable name must start with a letter or underscore character. We should not start name with number. And our variable name should be either alphabetic or alphanumeric. Don't include special characters like hash, star, percentage. Don't use that symbol in the declaration of variable name. Just you start the variable name with either letter or either or underscore character. For example, here dollar age, this age, see the letters all are in small alphabets, and here dollar age, A-G-E, again see the letters, all letters are capital. These both variables having same spellings, but the difference in between letters, case sensitivity. These are small letters, these are capital letters. So in PHP these both variables are different. This is not a same variable, because PHP variables are case sensitive. If you declare the variable with small letters, you have to use the variable with small letters only. If you declare the variable with capital letters, you have to use the variables with capital letters only. While declaring, use dollar symbol at the starting and then start the name with either alphabet or underscore letter. You can write any number if you want while declaring the name of variable, but don't use or avoid the use of special characters like star, hash, percentage, ampersand, like that. Don't use that symbols. These are the rules for declaration of variable. Now, variable, where we are declaring the variable, where we are using that variable, depending on that, there are some types of variables. We will see type of PHP variables or scope of variable. It is also known as scope of variables. First is global, second one is local, and third one is static. See, global, the name is indicating global, means we can use that variable overall the program. For that purpose, we need to declare this variable outside a function. Inside a PHP tag, we need to declare the variable outside the function. And if we want to access this variable inside the function, then we should write global keyword in front of that variable name. Outside the function, no need to write any global keyword. But inside the function, if we want to use this global variable, we need to write global keyword. In case of local variable declared inside a function and it is accessed inside a function. We can't use it outside the function. Next variable is static variable. Once we declare the variable and once we print the name of that variable, the value of that variable is deleted after printing. After using of that variable, the value becomes zero or the value deleted. So, if we want to continue with the same value, then we should use static keyword or we should use static variable. We can use this static variable inside the function with the static keyword and it can be accessed inside a function and it keeps the value static, means after printing the variable, it will not delete the value of that variable. So, this is the type of variables or scope of variables that are three types: global, local, and static. We'll see how to declare these variables. See, this is PHP tag. Inside PHP tag, here I declared one variable, A equal to 10, B equal to 5. Now these both variables are global, as I declared it under this PHP tag and outside the function. These are global variables. If I want to access these global variables inside the function, I need to write keyword global. I need to write keyword global. Here, global dollar B. Without using this global keyword, the variable will be local. Next, this dollar D. This is local variable. This is local variable. Here I forgot to write end of curly braces. First I will write here. This dollar $d is a local variable as we declared it inside this function. Inside the function, my function, this is d is, this d is local variable, and the static variable having value 1, c is equal to 1. Means when I print the value of this c in this function, it will not become 0, or it will not become whatever the 1 I given. We will see it with example in next lecture. Static C. While declaring the static variable, we need to use keyword static. While using the global variable, we need to use the keyword global. For declaring or using of a local variable, we need not to use any keyword. We can write the variable inside the function and we can use it inside the function as it is. This is all about with variables. So students, do you understand? PHP stands for Hypertext Preprocessor. This is, previously it was known as personal homepage, that's why its short form is PHP. Nowadays it is known as Hypertext Preprocessor. This is open source language used for general purpose and used as a server-side scripting language. It is platform independent and it can support a wide range of databases. Database means what? Database means the information stored in tabular format, or database means information stored in table, and the information is, or data stored in table, and it can be easily accessible. It can easily add, or it can easily edit. It can easily update. That means database. So it is supporting a wide range of database. It is easy to learn and run efficiently on server side. What are the features? Features are, the PHP is very simple, easy to learn, easy to run. It is interpreting language, no need of compilation. It is faster, executing faster than JSP and ASP. It is open source, no need to pay money. We can use it freely. Platform independent, can be supported or can be executed on any platform or any operating system. That's why platform independent, case sensitive, but regarding with only variable names. Error reporting, it is immediately give us error or report us the error as it has some predefined errors. It stores some predefined errors. It keeps the summary of access, summary of users who accessed or who logged in. That's why it is real-time access monitoring. And a loosely typed language means we can use the data types without declaring variables, without declarings. We can use the variables without declaring. Directly we can use the variable. That's why it is also known as loosely typed language. Next, it variable declaration. How we need to declare the variable? With a dollar symbol, and variable name must start with letter or underscore character. Don't use any number or number at the starting. Don't use any number at the starting. We can write either alphabets or alpha numeric format for declaration of variable name. The names are case sensitive, so if you declare the variable with small letters, use it as it is. If you declare with capital letters, use it as it is. Both variables are different. Here see the example. dollar age and here also dollar age, but age here small letters, here capital letters. Next, type of variables or scope of variables. Variables may be global, local or static. Global means we need to declare outside the function and can use inside the function as well as outside the function. But when we are using inside the function, we need to use a global keyword. While used outside the function, no need to use any keyword. Local variable means the variable which we are declaring inside the function and which we are using inside the function. That is local. Static